everybody. This is Roberto Blake of RobertoBlake.com, helping you create something awesome today with my friend Tim Schmoyer from Video Creators.
Hey.
So, for those who don't know, where can they find you, Tim?
You find me at youtube.com/videocreators. This channel is all about helping you guys grow your YouTube audience, just similar to what Roberto does here.
Exactly. So today, the topic we want to cover is staying motivated on YouTube. I read all of your comments, believe it or not, and I've seen in the comments that a lot of you are struggling with this. Your channel may not be growing as fast as you like. You may not be having the reach that you think you want for your message or what you're trying to accomplish. And so we want to talk a little bit about that. Tim, I know you have some thoughts on this.
Yeah.
What are you thinking?
Discouragement on YouTube is such a big deal, right? I mean, we all feel like we have certain expectations that should be like met really quickly, usually. And I found that whatever your goals are for going into your channel determines a lot of how you feel about your channel going forward. So, for example, if the goal of your channel, you know, for you is like, I just want to feel popular, I just want views, I just want subscribers.
Oh, you mean the thing that most people want on YouTube?
And there's nothing wrong with that, right? But we'll talk about the perspective of that in a second. But if you don't get those things, then like we get discouraged because of like a blocked goal or a goal that's not meeting our expectations, right?
Or we feel frustrated because we feel like it's being impeded by some external force.
Right, yeah. So all you have to do is change your goal, you know, and to really start like feeling excited about this game. So for example, on my channel, and I know this is true for Roberto's as well, it's not just about views and subscribers. Like both of us care a lot about the people in our channels. I know Roberto cares deeply about you. He reads all of your comments, right? What does that say about Roberto, like what he thinks about you guys? Like, for both of us, it's about like human connection. It's about connecting with people. It's about serving you guys the best that we can. And so if that's like the main mission, like the main goal, like Roberto and I both don't pay attention to the stats nearly as much as some of you guys do. And it's not because, oh, you're already big, whatever. No, it's not. It's because like we actually, like let's say we had 100 subscribers, like that's 100 freaking people that we get to serve, you know?
I have 40 people in my mentoring group, and I'm in there day in and day out with them, like no matter what.
Yeah. And we get excited about doing it because that's our goal, right? And so for you guys, maybe like your goal is, you know what, I just want to encourage moms who are frustrated, you know, or feeling alone at home, or kids who are feeling bullied. You know, it doesn't have to be something like really like some big mission.
I wanted to help creative people stop being starving artists, and I wanted to help make their careers better because it was hard on me. Mm-hmm. It was really hard on me.
Right.
And that was like the whole thesis behind this channel.
Right. And so if that's your goal, and that's what you get really excited about, like that's what your passion is. Like the passion isn't growing the channel itself. The channel is just a tool that helps you accomplish your actual passion.
And the community, whatever it is, whatever the size, that's your people, that's your tribe, that's your group. Those are the people who are like you.
Mm-hmm.
Remember what like Hank says about, Hank Green says about, find the people who are crazy, stupid, excited about the same thing you're crazy, stupid, excited about.
Yeah, yeah.
When I was a nerd and an artist and a kid growing up and everything like that, it was really rough on me. Like, and I keep saying that because it's like, I know that's a lot of you. You were bullied, you got, you know, whatever. It was not cool in the 90s to be a nerd in an era of like Steve Urkel and Carlton Banks. It was like, is it like extraordinary?
Steve Urkel's pretty cool though.
I agree. I'd like to invent a rocket pack or a transformation saber. I thought that was...
He was like a cool nerd.
I thought that was boss. Maybe not everyone agreed, but like, But finding those people.
Jimmy Neutron's my favorite.
Oh, God, yes.
Sorry, we're getting off track.
Inspector Gadget, and like, we geek out all the time.
Yeah.
Like, but like being into that stuff and everything like that, I had to find the people at the lunch table that liked that stuff with me too.
Yeah.
And sometimes that was only three or four people, but they, you know, became my best friends in the whole world.
Right.
So it's the same thing.
Remember that every view on your channel, every subscriber represents an actual person. Right? So you have 100 people like subscribe to your channel. You had 10 people subscribe to your channel. Like, there's people here, we're at VidCon right now, who have flown halfway across the world to speak to a room of 10 people.
Yeah.
You know?
That's real.
And they spend a lot of money, they put a lot of their time away from their families and business stuff and want to do that because it's that important. You guys, we get to do that, you know?
Every day.
Yeah, with like 10 people. That's awesome, you know? So don't it's hard to say just don't get discouraged, because it's like, well, don't be angry. Like, well, I am, you know.
No, that's a human emotion.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with that, but I just want, like, we encourage you guys, like, think bigger, like, what's actually happening on your channel, what you're actually accomplishing there, and think about it in terms more than just stats and analytics. The goal of the channel is not to just rack up those numbers, it's to make a difference in the world, I think.
Yeah, I think people have to have a bigger goal beyond YouTube. Any of this is not something altruistic. It could be a business goal or an ambition of some kind, or maybe you just want to improve your craftsmanship in terms of what you're making, everything. I mean, with me, people ask all the time, when did you get your first 100, when did you get your first 1,000? I don't know. I have to, like, use the Wayback Machine to find out. Why? Because I'm an artist. I'm neurotic. I was obsessed with the audio levels not being right. I was obsessed with, like, you know, not liking my speech cadence, my on-camera performance, all of my things that caused me anxiety that should technically would have stopped me from doing this in the first place.
Yeah.
I was obsessed over improving so much that I was grateful that no one was paying attention while I was, like, in my mind, messing up or not doing well. I feel like my first videos, like, were horrible.
Yeah.
Go back and watch them, and you see my point. I think I'll link some down below for you, because, like, if you go back, the odds are anything you're making today is much better than my first couple of attempts.
Yeah, mine, too. It's terrible. I have a challenge for you guys. My challenge would be, in the comments below of Roberto's video here, is what is a win for your channel? And you cannot define it in terms of views or subscribers. Take the numbers off the table. Think about it in terms of people, in terms of creativity or entrepreneur or business, whatever it is. Think about it in terms bigger than just numbers and stats, and then define what a win is. If I had a win on my channel, it would look like blank, or it would be blank, you know? And I'd really like to hear what you guys think about that and what that is for you.
That's powerful, Tim. Like, I think in general, people, if they just redefine what success is, what a win is, if they, like, not necessarily completely shift their goal, but if they look at it from a different perspective, if they take a step back.
What we're not saying is, like, lower your standards and make a win, like, hey, if I upload a video, for some of you that would be a win, right? Like, uploading a video would be like a first step because you're nervous and haven't done it yet. Like, that would be a win.
With my anxiety, getting out of my house is a win. Okay.
Yeah, us introverted people talk better to cameras than real people for a reason, right?
Yes, exactly. Like, most YouTubers are introverts, and most YouTubers have that problem. I mean, we don't talk about it as much.
Yeah. So think about that win, and it can be different for different people, but I'm looking forward to seeing what that is.
I'm absolutely looking forward to that. Guys, if you found this helpful, please go ahead and you know, leave that comment. Tell us your feedback on whether or not this has maybe motivated or inspired you to just think about things differently, and plus leave that win. We definitely want to see it. Also, go check out Tim's channel. If you feel like you need help with YouTube, this is one of the smartest and most caring guys I've ever met in the YouTube space. He's really for creators. So if that is what you're dealing with and you're struggling with, Tim's got plenty of help and plenty of advice over on his channel. So you can check that out at youtube.com/videocreators.
You got it. Look forward to seeing you guys.
All right. Go out there, create something awesome today.
See you guys.
Take care.